Welcome back to the show. Now, we've let you know what is trending and what you need to have in your closet for both the ladies and the gentlemen, but we need to also let you know what you need to stop doing, especially in this new month. That's what you have for the ladies.
Now, for the ladies, myself being such a great fashion lover, I received lots of complaints.
I thought you were going to say a great fashionista. It's going to stop you right there. Like, don't say that.
What do you mean?
You're not
my
fashionista.
My look is in my dress.
No, honey, you're a fashion guy. Like, okay, Kanye West.
Moving on. Well, I've received complaints from the guys at the Uganda Wildlife Authority.
Okay.
Don't laugh.
These guys are your friends?
No, like I said, myself being
you
a great fashion
WhatsApp
lover.
And you, like, tweet them.
No. They looked for me and they told me, you know what, that will help us talk to the ladies who are doing animal print from head to toe. Oh. You guys look like poachers. You need to stop doing that stuff.
You
honestly
need to stop
speaking.
Doing that.
You need to stop doing it. No, this is what happens. A lady rocks up in a jumpsuit, animal print, preferably. Let me go with leopard print.
Okay.
Leopard print. She's putting on shoes with the same print.
Leopard print.
Her accessories. She has a belt and she has a headband or a scarf.
Yeah, ladies.
And then she has a purse.
I'm just saying.
No, in 2013, they didn't call you. If you really, really feel the need to go all leopard and stuff like that, switch to National Geographic. See it, watch the wild animals and all that stuff. Honestly speaking, it's not a good look. It's not a good look. And in the event that someone shoots you with a bow and arrow, you cannot defend yourself. Honestly speaking.
Who is walking out with a bow and arrow in Kampala?
People who are getting the animals back.
Heyra.
I'm a hater?
Yeah, you're fashion.
Out with a chick putting on animal print from head to toe.
I'm not the one with friends from Wildlife Organization, obviously.
Ladies, here's the thing. This year, try to be a bit sophisticated. Be classy.
Okay.
It does not hurt.
Talking about sophistication and class, for the gentlemen, not everyone should be wearing skinny jeans. I mean, just because they're called skinny jeans doesn't mean that,
again.
They're going to slim you down. I have a problem.
They shouldn't be... Like, some people wear them like they're leggings.
I have a problem when I find a guy, you have a pot belly, right? You have very narrow hips, you have no beanies.
So what's your issue here? Is it the guy's physique?
Exactly. You know, Tattoo, I personally, I know some
they
clothes.
They woke up
no,
like that.
Listen, I personally, well, they woke up like that. Yeah. No, I have a problem with, I know this as a fact. There's some clothes I cannot wear because I know they don't look good on me.
Good.
People should know that because you cannot wear each and everything in fashion. Let me tell you more, you know, be a kid, some people with a certain body type.
Yeah.
Now, you have a pot belly going and you're wearing skinny jeans. The pot belly is going to sit on your skinny jeans, you
on
know. You have narrow hips. Your jewels are all there for the whole world to see.
No, if you're putting on jeans that tight, they are no longer jewels.
What are they?
Something really, I don't know.
I mean, guys, if you have a poor belly, you're big, you have narrow hips, no beanies, let's leave the skinny jeans for those people who actually have amazing physiques. Now that graduation is out of the way, the next step might be looking for a job. But how about you already have the job and just need to show up at work looking perfect? Well, today I'm going to be letting you know, all the fellas back at home, how you can get a power suit that will leave a statement back at work. The first thing you have to do is nail the fit. We don't want you to be wearing something baggy because you find that most young men these days wear very baggy outfits and they look borrowed, and that is not the kind of thing you want to be remembered for at work. So the first thing you need to do is nail the look. Add a little bit of color. The gentleman here is wearing this burgundy blazer. This works perfectly well because it leaves a lasting memory in your co-workers' head. When they want to remember you, they remember your impeccable sense of fashion. Let's talk about a little bit of accessories and details. He has a pocket square here. Now, what this pocket square does, it has a little bit of personalizes the outfit. Now, not everyone's gonna wear a pocket square, but if you wear a pocket square like this one, very detailed, a bit of African, it leaves a lasting memory in someone's head. When your co-workers want to suggest someone for a promotion, trust me, they'll remember the pocket square, they'll remember you, and you'll be the guy to go for. Now remember, if you want to buy any suit, the first thing you have to get are the pants. Black pants work perfectly well for each and everybody and can actually be played around with. If you're going to wear a black coat, it will work perfectly well. If you want to wear any other kind of coat, it will work perfectly well on the black trousers. So the first thing you need to nail is make sure you get yourself a pair of black trousers. Let's talk about the shoes. The model here is wearing shoes, but you don't need to be wearing black shoes each and every time. Remember that today there are very many different styles of shoes out there and very many different colors. Like today I'm wearing these brown shoes. So remember, these are the little things you need to keep at the back of your mind. First of all, nail the feet. Add a little bit of accessory to personalize your outfit. Black pants and your shoes. Those are the basic things you need to know before you go out to your new job. Well, from me and Tato, we say good luck, and we hope you get that promotion very fast.
Thanks, Moshe. Now, for the ladies, it's just as simple as this. Number one, you do not have to have a hemline anywhere above your knees. Nobody wants to see your knees. Nobody is interested in your knees, unless, of course, you're applying for those jobs that start after 7 p.m. I'd really, really advise a hemline below your knees. Away from that, the accessories. Keep it as simple as possible. Be classy, be elegant. We know you have very, very many chunky necklaces and chains and jewels, but unless this first job of yours is somewhere in a, I don't know, a music studio and stuff like that, I'd really, really recommend you go as simple or as plain as possible. Not danglers like mine. My job calls for this. But, go with pins, they're better. If you have tattoos all over your arm, I'd advise you go and put a long-sleeved shirt on and stuff like that. Do not carry the excessively huge bag. It will scare away the guys. They'll think you want to steal some of the office equipment and stuff like that. But also, do not walk in with just a wallet or those clutches you carry to the nightclub. Keep it simple, keep it classy, look as sophisticated as possible. So those are all the tips we have for you guys. I think it's about time we say bye.
The one thing we love about you guys is that you guys watch each and every week. We love you so much for that, and we need to keep in constant communication with you guys. That's why we have a Facebook page. Time to let them know.
Well, just go to the search engine, type The Urban Fashionista, like it, invite 1,000 of your friends, and let us know what you love about the show, what you'd like to suggest, who you'd love to see on the show. If you want me to send Moshe away and get another dude onto the show, it's all good. Just let us know.
It's all good. Let me ask you, how many followers are on Twitter right now?
2,800.
You said 2,000? I'm coming. I have 2,100 and something right now. That's a very
good
milestone.
I say 2,800. You know the difference between 800 and 100?
Well, I'm coming
it's
for
700.
You. I'm coming for you. Well, you can follow me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is @Moshiology. Tab doesn't need you to follow her because she has like 1,000 followers. But if you want to follow her just to help her, she's a tattoo zero.
Let's talk Instagram. How many followers do you have on Instagram?
I have like 700 something.
But no, Moshe. How many followers do you have on Instagram?
700.
Okay.
How many do you have?
1,000 something.
This
but
is so embarrassing. This is embarrassing.
Well, guys,
Lord
Danzen. Yes, yeah. Lord Danzen. It's fine. Tattoo 02.
Same thing. Well, we love you so much for watching. We'll see you again next week. But do this. Let us know who you want to see on the show and what you need us to talk about on the show. Ask us any question, and we shall be sure.
I need to shout out to my main homie.
Shout out.
You see, Moshe did not wake up like this. Why? Because I watched I watched Ahumuza Brian put this together, and I think he has such great talent. You can look like Moshe, by the way. All it takes is a few, you know, shillings. Just go to Garden City at the basement and check out A. Brian. He does a good job. Or can go to Prime Complex.
Exactly. And if you've seen any outfit on the show today, we got all those from A. Brian's collection. Yes. So make sure you go there to get yourself.
Please don't come here looking for this dress. because you will not find it. You can find it though at Equatorial Mall, Runway House of Fashion. Till next week, be good, take care.
She walk out like that. Good night, guys. We love you so much for watching. Cheers. See you next week.